Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Beyond the Mask. Today I want to actually discuss something pretty different. I was going to do a video that was analysing the character of Tara Carpenter, because I seem to have been covering quite a few characters from the latest Scream movie, and she's the only one that's not really had much coverage. But the interesting thing is that I've discovered something about this character that no one seems to have picked up on and no one seems to have said before. So without further ado, let me get into this video by telling you exactly what it is I have discovered. When I'm doing these kind of videos and I'm sort of researching and discussing, you know, different aspects of the characters and analysing areas that we may not be aware of, I always tend to try and sort of write down who I believe the character represents from previous Scream installments. And surprisingly enough, most of the characters from the latest Scream movie do sort of mirror characters from the 1996 movie. Some of them do spread over sequels, but they mainly go into Scream. But Tara was quite an interesting one, because on one hand, her character was sort of based on Casey Becker due to her opening scene, but there's that many references to Casey Becker, and even though she has a couple of scenes where it alludes to Casey Becker and you can draw comparisons, I don't believe that Tara was a representation of Casey Becker. So here's the most interesting bit. I believe Tara was a representation of a character that wasn't even in the Scream franchise. And I'm going to tell you how Tara Carpenter was based on Laurie Strode from the Halloween franchise. I remember seeing this image, and this image shows Laurie Strode's scene in Halloween 1978, which draws a parallel to Tara's. One of my favourite sequences in Scream 2022 was the hospital scene. When I was actually watching this the other day, I noticed that the scene draws a lot of parallels to Halloween 2, and Tara sort of representing Laurie Strode in a way. If you take notice in these scenes, if you haven't seen Halloween 2, Laurie Strode ends up in a hospital because Michael Myers has attacked her and she's broken her leg from the attack. Gradually, as the movie goes on, the hospital is completely abandoned because there's hardly any staff there as it is, and Michael Myers does sort of kill the staff off. And eventually, she becomes suspicious of how alone she is in this hospital. And then upon leaving the hospital room, she then becomes aware that something's not right. And then that scene turns into Michael Myers chasing Laurie Strode through the hospital. And eventually it leads with a scene in which an older figure comes in who's dealt with the killer before and eventually ends up sacrificing his life in favour of protecting that main girl. So why is this interesting? Well, when I've been doing videos and discussions with you guys, you've all been sort of saying that the character of Tara was better than what Sam Carpenter was and you preferred her, and the two girls sort of became final girls. But I believe that was completely intentional. I believe that what Scream 2022 was doing was creating a Sidney Prescott and a Laurie Strode within the same universe. I believe these two characters were meant to be the final girls, and I believe that the whole idea was to combine two of the most famous final girls into one movie. And regardless of what you think about this opinion, if you don't agree with me, that's fine. You cannot deny that the hospital scene was very reminiscent of Halloween 2, and I absolutely loved that, because Halloween 2 was one of my favourites from that franchise. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Don't forget to like the video. That lets me know that you're enjoying this content. Without further ado, I'm going to leave this video on a quote from Tara Carpenter.
I still prefer the Babadook.
You like scary?